So then we will now use technology to support. I call it the TIB, right? As I was doing like January, March, April, May, I was, all the lessons were online. So it was very tough starting online. Then I started looking at it and said, is there a way I'm able to get the students to do a few things like what we call the strategy, learning objective. So am I able to go through number one? Second is question them, critical thinking. Next, of course, I get into key concept. And finally, I look into the overview. So I have a four main things to look at when I start using technology. Now, we have learned something earlier on. Now, how do I incorporate it into a lesson, right? Actual lesson. So this is what I will probably call it, think in boxes. Most of us say think out of a box. For myself, I believe in thinking in a box. So just give you an example. So this is your whole, the call it a slide. So if I were to show this to all, they will look at it. They cannot focus, right? There's no focus. They look at it. Then as you talk, you will realize that only auditory is only 4%, which means only 4% will listen to you on the when you talk. So you have a screen here. Then the other, I will call 51% will look at this. And then 15% kinesthetic, 29% kinesthetic. So you need to capture about 4%. So how do you make it a visual, right? How do you capture the visual part? So that's where we thinking in boxes come along. So the first thing is learning objective. So I will go in and say, how do I go about thinking in boxes? We'll use this, right? Look at it. I will bring out the annotate. So let me go back to here. So you will probably see this. So first thing I do is I will have this slide. I need to know exactly what I would like the learner to go back with, right? So it's quite meaningless. This slide, it doesn't mean anything to them. So in terms of the all the educators here, we said this is the most important Bloom's taxonomy learning level we need to. So when we are, my first question earlier on was, say, how creative or artistic are you? There was a purpose behind that question. The question raised is basically because if I were to go in, my main purpose, now if I go to the annotate, I will go in and say important. So what I do is I will say, I will put it into a very thick line and then I will draw a box. I say, this is the level we are going to reach. Can you see that? This is the level I'm going to reach. I said, I would like learners to reach this level. So it's just a simple part. They see it, they hear me talk, and then they will be able to see that particular focus. If you do not like this, you can basically go through and say, all right, maybe I would like to use a circle instead. So use this circle and say, this is the level we try to achieve, right? And that is how I get the students to pick up the learners and they say, oh, okay, creative. So we need to create a platform. And then the main thing about creating is about parts. So see, you can't see the red color. So what you need to do is be aware. And then you go in and says, all right, I need to have a color. So I use the yellow color to go in and say about parts. Now parts go back to the starting point about how you are going to analyze the parts. Let's see a new color again. So you need to change. So this is something that takes a bit of time used to it. I'm using a mouse, so I don't need to use the pen so far. So I think most of us have a mouse, quite straightforward. You try to draw, it's very tedious. Initially, when I start drawing it, it was like quite not that great. It was trying to figure out how do I draw this. Then I will be going in and then started a lot of time. So exactly what I did when I first started teaching. I said, how do I do? Ah, there's an arrow there. You all know about this. So drawing whole new, see, it's not neat. So remember the part relating to saving. So you take note. After doing this, do save it. Right? Ah, there someone did it today. So now, if you have a breakout room, that's good. Breakout room, you just go in, let the learners can do the breakout room. Now, so far, I've not used any other technology. It's just using the Zoom or you have your own video conferencing. Now, not that great. Why? Because my take on this is, for example, just now I see a lot of people coming in. Right? It's not an individual worksheet, I call it. So this is good for collaborative learning. So those who come in, some may mess up the whole place, so I would say. So you have to control this in a way. So you do see that sometimes you have to clear it, clear all drawing. And then each time, okay, for the Zoom part, before we move on to the next slide, let's give an example how I learn by mistakes. After a while, I do all this. No, that's my drawing, right? So what happened is, I then go ahead and I say, I went to the next slide, right? I close the annotation and move to the next slide. Then what happened was the next slide, you see? It's a mess. See that? So you must remember to go back to the earlier slide here and then open the annotation, annotate, clear all drawings, right? And then you're okay. Then you're in an actual work lesson or workshop, I will do this way, right? I will go in, I say, okay, when you analyze, you are looking into taking parts. Second, you evaluate, is this part relevant or not? Then third part is then you create the whole picture. So what I did is, of course, my theory, I do mind mapping. So I have that particular idea of whole part, whole thinking, right? That's one. So you may think of other things. I do concept map as well. Concept map is also good. Every subject I do, I have a concept map before I go in, so that students, learners will have it. Be familiar. You may like certain things like the color in boxes. So one concept is called box it, or we call it thinking in boxes, right? So far, just use the simple annotation, clear all drawing, then we will now go to the next level. So this is what we will see. So now this is learner's input. So today what I've done is I have gotten in, what is this all about here? This basically means from the learner's point of view. So when we see this, we will probably get the learner, the students will see this and they will write. Now, of course, the writing here is not that easy. This is using, I would call it, some of the learners have the tablet, iPad with a pencil, with a stylus. That is the ability to write. So this is something that's written with the stylus, right? Those without stylus will find it difficult to write. So they may advise them to type. This is where my name is here. So this is what I will see in my part here, right? So you do see the input from the learner. Now, what you can do for this part, identify where is creativity skill in the year 2015. So I get the learners to think about where is this. So they start doing analysis, finding out. So they go to 2015. Yes. Will you be able to find the creativity skills in 2015? If you can, you will either circle it or box it. Can anyone find? Okay, good. Someone put a love sign. Okay, a heart sign there. Yes. All right. Good. Then what you do next is you do into a critical thinking. Then in the year 2020 is there. All right, good. So y'all can see the matching point. Now then the whole overview. So from 2015 to 2020, how much has it moved up? So you can draw a connecting arrow from 10 to number 3. So you do see, connecting, draw all the way up. That's it. So this is what we call the critical thinking skills. So a few things happen here. So you can also do the rest. So my focus is on look at creativity. It is quite interesting. How is it that the creativity level went down from down 10 to up? So a lot of mess now. So you can save this as I call it Picasso drawing. Then you still look at it and says, in terms of the rest, it's still very important. Focus on this. This has not changed. That is the learning process. So whether you are the 2015 or 2020, complex problem solving skills will always be there. I can't change. Then critical thinking skills are a bit up. And strange. So again, think about it. How is it that the other part here, coordinating with others, went down? Right. So you got them to think about it rather than just look at this, and you will be able to have a discussion later on. So far, this is just the use of a particular method. So your slides, right? So let me clear all this. So when you have your slides here, what you see is this. So when you're looking at it, then you create something visual, allowing them to map. So the designing part is quite important. In fact, this slide was done the other way around. When it was, you can search for this online, It was 2020 and 2015. So I shifted it, right? So I give it the time zone from left to right. So far, thinking in boxes, number one. So this is where you will see my desk. Very simple desk, right? Nothing fanciful. I don't have the mic. So that's what I do. I use, besides that, I use quite a lot of other technology in your pod. So you will see a coffee cup here, right? Just to, during break time. So what do I use that really help differentiate? Is this particular, okay, can you guess which one I use the most? You can circle it. Which one do I use the most? Before coffee cup. Yeah, that's right. Coffee cup as well. This is the one, correct. So I give you an answer. This is the one. Now, when I started doing this part, this is the pad. If you are able to invest, search for this. Welcome. They call it online. It really makes a big difference. So I will share with you how it looks like. So in terms of this, if you have to write something like that, it's very difficult to write. See, it's not easy. So if you have a pen, then it changes the way you write. So this is how it will look like. Smooth. Right? So investment, first part is this. This is the investment. Now, the only issue is when some of the lecturers approach me, they say, there is no more stock. It's not out of stock. You can Google it and see whether you can find it. It's a WACOM.
Wacom. Right? Yeah.
Right, got it. It's really helpful. Less than $100. I think there are cheaper ones also. Colors. Right, this is the second point. If you recall, I like to draw a lot. So then the question is, am I able to do something that can help me to have a color board? I go beyond white color. My concept is, after a while, everyone see white color a bit boring. So what I do is I use color boards. So you're wondering what is color board? Color boards is the concept, just like post-it notes. Right? Post-it notes have different colors, correct? Then people get a bit more excited. It changes the tone. A visual person will look at it and say, oh, okay. Now, Zoom has only got whiteboard. There's no colors to it. No? So think creatively. How do you create color boards? Right, maybe you can see a chat board here. Can you create color boards? Let's see. Anyone have any idea of color boards? Put a box in color. Got it. Let's give a reward for that. Right. Yeah, that's it. Easier than that. Okay, I'll just let you know, easier than that. What you do is you prepare beforehand. When you have your slides with you, right? This whiteboard. I do not use whiteboard. So I just go in and say, how do I have a color board? So I go in. This is what you do. In your PowerPoint slide, just put in this from PowerPoint slide, a shape, and put a color you like. So I have many colors. See? So it creates a different tone. So if important, you may put a red color. Then now, the second part is this. If I have to put a black color, see what happens. You have to change your color, isn't it? See? Quite fun. Then you all do it. So it forces the learner to switch, which means within that particular period of time, I've done something called a creative environment for them, right? They do not just use the basic color. They use a lot of colors to come in and say, oh, okay, at least it's not the same as a normal class, right? So you do see, quite nice, right? The background, so you change it, so it changes the color. So you can have a very fun way of going through this. You all choose, which color do you like? I like black color. Black color is very nice to look at, right? Very Steve Jobs type. Steve Jobs is always black color. No black color, one whole black and then a bit of white. So quite soothing. Okay. So see, I didn't change any. I just move on from slide to slide. So from here, you can put in your own drawing. Okay, let's do this activity. You teach a subject, whether it's a concept map, mind map, then you will just go in and say, all right, let's continue. So what we have done so far, what does it mean by this particular branch here? Will you talk, when can you not design? When can you redesign? See, so I draw this with the mouse. Then of course you talk about technology. So what technology do you use? In terms of, so far we have used Zoom. So I will explain to them. Zoom is the one I've used. So this is Zoom. What other technology do you use? Ah, then draw a line. You can add in. So we have an interaction here. What technology do you use?
So I just have a question from a participant asking, what's the difference between a concept map and a mind map?
Oh, okay. Concept map and mind map. Right, this is a mind map. Okay, mind map. So, good example. So I clear all this drawing. This is a mind map. So let me give me some time to do this. Mind map. So a central image. And then you branch out. Yeah. Right, this is a mind map. And then you will go in. Now, mind map is a bit more free flow because you can start from left to right, whatever it is. You will have this box here. Key idea. A mind map will have it in the center. Then from a concept map point of view, you have 4 points just now, right? 1, 2, 3, 4. This is a concept map. How it works is, you will then go in and say, all right, I will connect these 4 points. This is a concept map. A hierarchy. So you have a top to bottom. So this is the topic. This sub 1, sub 2, sub 3, sub 4. Later on, I will share with you this particular idea. Basically, you can put it into, I will call it, a software, right? A free software that I share with you. Down here, mind map. Mind map is a bit more free flow. Mind map uses colors. So you have one branch, sub number one, then go down to number two. So if you look at concept map, you can use your, I will call it, you use this to draw a concept map. And then the next moment you just go in and then this is a concept map. The other one, mind map, is a bit more, here and then it goes in and goes in and goes in, right? And then it goes to branches, a bit more creative. So between a mind map and a concept map, you use whichever one you like, right? Looks like a COVID-19. Okay. This mind map. Mind map is a bit more free flow. Some, if you do not have the time to, this is using an iPad to draw. So I'm moving everything into technology. All this is hand drawn. And this is what you see. So the learner will put in. The question today is, learners able to do mind mapping? The answer is so far no issues because you give them a structure, a basic structure. Now, this is a concept map. Good question. Maybe I anticipated the question. Concept map, mind map. This is a concept map. Clean, easy to do, right? I like concept map because it's very easy. All you need to do is just use PowerPoint slide, the box, do the connector. So let's go through this activity. So what do you remember about the left-hand side? Content. Depending on your level, the students, your learner's level. So for a starting point, I usually go through this. Or you can add in. If you look through it, see, it's very difficult to type right in. You realize that it's not easy because you don't have the part. Exactly what my learners go through. So what they do is type in. Now, this is something which I picked up along the way, just recently. You know, in fact, before that, I don't do such things. Then I realized that some learners need to have it's like a puzzle to them. This blank, they like to see all this. Then they fill in the blank. So it gives them a lot of confidence. Because it's totally blank one. They really can't think about it. See, so this is what we call think in blank. It's very creative. So you do see this. So concept map is very neat. Concept map, think in boxes. Right? I would call it think in boxes, second round. That's why think in color. See the colors? So in terms of your way to look at things, do not just put a normal, a plain white color. Try to put some colors in, right? Then I left a lot of spaces here. So in case anybody who asks questions about things, you can always ask questions here. So concept map, mind map, so you decide. So I'll give you two ways to look at it. This is a concept map. So maybe you can do a poll, mind map, right? Concept map, mind map. Yeah. Which one do you all think is a better use for you? So far, I've not redesigned much. I've added in to the content, right? No redesigning involved. It's just one overview. And I call this reflection as well. Time to reflect. Like earlier on, we go through, then after that, I said, oh, I can't remember anything. What happened earlier on? We don't really know. So it's called reflection. Two parts. One is critical and creative thinking. Mind map has been promoted as a creative visual thinking tool. And that's one. Concept map is a lot more structured.